So the other week I was at the WFX conference in Louisville, Kentucky, and I met these guys from NEMOSYN, and they got this little gadget here. I think you can see it. And basically what it does is it does a multitrack off of the X32 mixer and the M32, so that whole family of mixers with that software. And basically, it's about the size, a little bit bigger than a phone, maybe. But as you can see, a big red button for record, green button for play. And it basically does the simple task of multi-tracking to an SD card. It's got a little SD slot right here, without the use of a laptop or anything like that. And you may be asking, well, you know, I've got tracks live or another DAW that I connect to my X32, and I use that to multi-track with. Well, the neat thing about this is, you know, with a laptop, especially at the gigs that I play, I mean, you've got a lot of equipment. You know, we do our own in-ears. I've got the drum kit, you know, cables, microphones, all kinds of cases and stuff. And the last thing I want to be worried about is a laptop sitting on a rack on the side of the stage or backstage or something. And that's usually, you know, after the gig or in between sets, that's something I got to go check and make sure that it's, you know, it's still working, you know, that if it's raining, it didn't get rained on. And this little gadget right here lets me do everything that I want to do, multi-tracking, and virtual playback too, although we don't do a lot of that with my band, but in the church format, we would use this a lot. So I was just making a little video. Gary and Matt were nice enough to give me, well, not give me one of these, but they let me take one of the prototypes for a little test spin here. And I've just been kind of giving them feedback. But so far, it works incredibly well. It's rock solid. The other night, I had a 128 gig SD card in here. And for 32 tracks, it does just over three hours of recording. But it's pretty simple. Hit record. And it's got a little meter bridge on the top. You can see all the meters going. You hit stop when you're done. And if you hit play, it'll play back the just most recent thing that you recorded. And if you flip your console, X32 or M32, whatever console you're using, and you flip it so that the USB is the inputs, and you can use that during by doing snippets, like a routing snippet on your board, which there's plenty of YouTube videos that show you how to do that, to make a quick key to flip the inputs to do a virtual sound check on those boards. But anyway, you hit playback, and you're playing right away. So, you know, at church here, how we're going to be using this like device like this is while the band's doing rehearsal, record maybe their final song at sound check, and then me as a worship leader or another worship leader in another room can go out front. Sound guy can hit play, and we can actually hear what it sounds like out front. It's hard to, for a worship leader that plays in the band, it's really hard to hear what it sounds like out front while you're playing on stage. So this will alleviate that. And again, there's no software or anything. It's really simple to use. It's rock solid. Haven't had any problems yet. And I'm going to show you, I'm kind of clipping these videos together from several days with working with this, but I will show you with a folder structure of when you pull that SD card out and you put it in your computer, what that looks like. Because that's a question a lot of people, you know, want to know, you know, how, you know, if I want to pull these off the SD card, what's it going to look like on my computer? So I'll show you that. But I just kind of just wanted to show you this little device, and I'm gonna and then hopefully at the end of the video I will play back some footage that we took at the gig the other night. So there it is.
Tonight we got a gig, got the X32 rack going, and we're gonna plug this in, and I'm just gonna show you how simple it is to use. So it's powering up here. Version 1.0A. So this is real time. This is how quick it takes or how long it takes to start up. Searching for the SD card, and it's ready to record. So I'm gonna hit record, and we're recording. So it'll do 3 hours right now on 128 gig card. And then at the end of the gig, I'll show you what happens when I pull the card out. So there it is.
So I just wanted to show a quick video of, I've got the SD card here on my desktop, and I just wanted to show you what the file structure is when I open it up. So there it is, end drive. And for each recording you do, there'll be a session-01, 02 example. And there you go. This was the whole 128 gig card. The only thing I noticed was is that it starts at 00 and goes to 31. So there's 32 tracks. So you can rename them and drop them in your favorite editing program of your choice. And that's how simple it is.
The nighttime, the city weeps a sleepless eye. Hear her voice shake my window, sweet seducing sigh. Get me out into the nighttime, for walls won't hold me tonight. An apple, then let me take a bite. They say, why, tell them that it's human nature. Why, do they give me that way? They say, why, tell them that it's human nature. Why, do they give me that way? Such a stranger, electric eyes are everywhere. See that girl, she knows I'm watching. She likes the way